Hey there, fellow creators. Ben here from Cinderblock Studios, and it's time again for another art supply giveaway. I am so excited for this one because not only am I giving away art supplies, but it's what I've kind of compiled it to be the ultimate drawing giveaway package that I could possibly muster. I've been building it for 2 months, and this is going to be an international giveaway. So if you want to learn how to get your name into this one and want to see what's in the box, stick around. Okay, so I'm just stupid excited for this, so much so that this video is going up a day early. One, because this giveaway is not going to be, I'm not going to have entries open super long. It's just going to be through the end of this month, so from the time this video goes up through probably 11:59 on October 31st, like the very end of the month. So that's all long I'm going to have it open. But there's a lot of good stuff in this package. So first, let's have a look at what you guys could be getting. Okay, so we are going to start small and work our way up. The first of these things, now, as I said in the intro, I'm kind of pulling a little bit from my excess and a little bit from things that I have bought. So the first thing is a collection of dip pen nibs. Now, unfortunately, I cannot include the actual dip pen holder for these because, one, you have to buy everything. You can't just get the holder. When you get a holder, they give you like four or five nibs or sometimes more. But this is a good starter set and an expansion set for what you may or may not already have. I also can't include any ink in this package because shipping internationally, specifically through the air, ink does not ship, fly super well. Also, these couple of little round ones that are in that set actually fit on the end of a feather. So if you're really desperate, you can shove it on the end of a feather. Next up, we have a pack of General's Jumbo Compressed Charcoal. Three different hardnesses here, at least I think so. It should be like soft, medium, and hard. If you're new to charcoal, never really tried charcoal before, these are a good starter for you. I'm also including the three standard erasers, the kneaded rubber, plastic, also sometimes called just white or vinyl eraser, and an art gum. All right, starting to bridge into pencil land. Before we get to pencil land, I'm including two of the, soapstone sticks. These are actually just marking sticks. You can get these at a hardware store, but I got a bunch of them back when I made the video on five art tools you can get at a hardware store, and I'm never going to use all of the ones that I have, so you get two of those. Next up, we have a collection of pencils from sort of my excess backstock of materials. Now, these four on the left actually came from my late friend Jim's art supplies, so you're just getting some of that older materials as well. Again, not going to go through all of that. I've got enough to last me the rest of my life. The two on the end are the General's Layout Drafting Pencils, number 555. These are just all-around great pencils, but I've got like six or eight of them, so I don't necessarily need all of them. The one next to that is a Coronor H pencil. This is what you might call a vintage H pencil. They don't look like this anymore, so getting one of these is just getting a slightly different paint job than what you might find in the store today. And there's also a General's Shading and Sketching pencil that's also big and flat. It's like the ones you get at the hardware store, and it's kind of already been sharpened out the way my friend had it. You're also getting a General Sketch and Wash. This is a water-soluble ink, allows you to do some watercolor techniques with graphite. And finally, there is a soft charcoal pencil, because I've got like three of those, and I don't need three of them. Next up, you're going to be getting a handful of the Prismacolor Ebony pencils. Now, I got a whole box of these, because I do tend to use a few of them, but you're going to be getting probably in the range of 4 to 6. I haven't actually decided yet. Love these pencils. Super dark, black, smooth, darkest pencils in the world, but they have a nice blendability to them, and I love using blending stumps with these. Speaking of nice dark pencils, I'm including this Create-A-Color Monolith Woodless Pencil Set, which I actually just found out has an eraser in it, so you're getting a fourth eraser. I love woodless pencils. I've really fallen in love with them over the years. That's partially why I'm including this particular set, but I'm actually really impressed by this little case. I'm tempted to keep it myself, but nope, you guys are getting that as well. Next up, we've got Conte à Paris, or maybe à Paris if you feel like being fancy. This is a whole set of Conte pastels, specifically for portrait artists. So you have a nice set of range of flesh tones, as well as a blue for, I guess, extra accents and things like that, and under under-level veins, and blue tends to be a nice color for portraits anyway. So really nice set of Conte crayons to kind of get you started on some basic dry media. In addition to the Conte, I'm also including a small half-stick set Rembrandt muted chalk pastels. This was actually one of the first things I picked up for this giveaway set. I'm like, you know what, I'm going to throw some chalk pastels in here and start building the drawing giveaway. And this is going to be a nice additional bit of color to use with those portrait Conte crayons. Now, I know what you're thinking. Hey, Ben, that's a lot of stuff. But guess what? We're not done yet. I'm also including a Canson XL bristle pad. Bristle paper is awesome. It's super smooth. It's super versatile. This tends to be a little bit thicker than your standard drawing paper. It's 100 pound, 160 grams. I love bristle paper. And for your bigger scale drawings, when you start to really play with this media and really use a lot of it, and like, okay, I want to take this to like a maybe a good finished drawing, this is going to be great paper for that. But we're still not done, because I'm finally also including an 18 by 24 sheet pad of newsprint. Newsprint is the go-to for things like charcoal and Conte crayon, that portrait stuff, especially if you're practicing. It's super thin. It's only 30 pound paper. I'm not sure what the grammage is on that. It's just 30 pound. But newsprint is the thing to use if you are just kind of getting started playing with dry media and trying to amp up the scale of your drawings. If you're not, again, unfamiliar with newsprint, it's slightly toned. It's not perfectly white. It's a little bit of a gray color. And what's great about it is you can put it up on an easel, work with it. And if you don't like the drawing, just rip it and throw it away, because it's, again, it's a thin, it's lightweight paper, and it's not a huge deal if you just crumble them up and get rid of it. Now you're thinking, okay, is that everything? That's everything you're going to see. I will also be including a few extra goodies specifically here from Cinderblock Studios, a couple of pieces of original art, as well as a couple of prints for you as well. But those will be up to you and to see as a surprise when you open up the pack. Now you're thinking, okay, how do I enter? How do I get all this stuff? Pretty simple. Steps. One, be 18 years or older to enter, or have parental permission to do so. I didn't mention that in last giveaway, and I actually ran into some problems on that one. Two, be a subscriber to this channel, because duh. Three, send me an email with the subject line, I want to draw, or I wanna draw, or some variation on that. Preferably one of those two. And four, only enter once. If you send multiple entries, you will be immediately disqualified. So, other than that, that's pretty much it. I mean, I would have to be able to get the shipment to you. So if you live somewhere that I can't do that, then obviously that would be a problem too. But hopefully you don't. And that's all you need to know to be entered into this contest. That's pretty much it. You have from now until, again, October 31st at 11:59 p.m. Eastern to get your entries in. And if you do that, you've got a shot at getting this boatload of drawing art supplies. It's been a tough year for a lot of people, and I'm hoping that this can bring a bit of joy just to at least one of you. So again, follow the rules, get your entries in, and I look forward to getting these art supplies in your hands. For more videos like this, stick around, and this has been from Cinderblock Studios. Keep on creating, and I'll see you guys next time.